We saw earlier how scaling, and then rotating, is often the most convenient order. With our snowman, the arms were positioned by rotating, then translating. Here's the stick without any transforms on it. I've made the snowman transparent and removed the ground plane so we can see the stick's position. It's actually inside the snowman, halfway through the ground. Whenever you create most geometric objects in 3JS, the object is centered around the origin. The rotation along the x-axis put the stick into its proper orientation. Then the translation moved it upwards in world coordinates to the proper location. Let's see what would happen if we first translated, then rotated. First, we move the stick upwards 50 units. The center of the stick is now in place in the middle of the body. So far, so good. Now, if we rotate the stick after positioning it, we suddenly see it lying on the ground. What happened? The problem is that the rotation takes place with respect to the origin. In the first step, we moved our stick up above the origin. In the second, we rotated the stick, but it rotated around the origin. Let's watch this disaster in slow motion. The stick starts centered at the origin. We move it upwards 50 units. Now its center is at the right height. However, when we then apply a rotation, the object rotates around the origin down here instead of rotating around its center. Finishing the 90-degree rotation, the stick's landed on the ground. Another way to think about it is that translating an object moves its center. You're moving the object up. Relative to the stick, you're moving the point it will rotate around down. We've established that scaling before rotating is usually what we want, and rotating before translating is also generally more useful. This is why 3JS uses this order: scale, rotate, translate, when dealing with a single object.